generating a details list. When the user selects a basic list by means of a double click or function key F2, the ABAP event at line selection is triggered. You must implement this in your program in the form of a corresponding processing block. You can read the data requested by the user and output them with the write statement. Hint: if an @selection block is implemented in the program, a push button with the magnifying glass symbol also appears above the list. Marking the list row and then choosing this button has the same effect as double clicking the list row, generating several details lists. The row selection on the detail list also triggers the @line_selection event. You must be able to determine within this block on which list the current row selection was made so that you can react adequately. You can use the scilesync system field for this. This field shows the current list level, 0 for the basic list, 1 for the first detail list, and so on. If you have more detailed list, it will go 2, 3, 4, etc. The value of the scilesync should be used to control processing in the @line_selection block. For example, we have a simple syntax example program. We have a start of selection, so we write the text 00. That text symbol is the basic list. And we write the system scilesync. Then at the @selection event, when we double click the basic list, then the scilesync is filled with 1, and when that happens we write the text 001, that is the first detail list. If that detail list then has the double clicked, then we will display the second detail list. So let's build this small program inside the system just to understand the basics of the basic list and generating second, third, or fourth detail lists. So let's go to the Object Navigator and create a new program for the detail list. So in our package ABAP course, we press Enter, right-click on Programs, and we create a new program. This is going to be called C details list without top include. And this is just a test for list. Executable program. And we save. I didn't notice that our language is in Spanish. So let's save. I'm going to log off and log on again one more time, but in English. So I'm going to close here. ABAP training. I'm sorry for the inconvenience. And yeah, continue with this logon. Now, yes, we go to our program. And we go to programs. Where is our program? Details list. Now we're ready. So let's test what we just saw in the presentation. So we write the start of selection event. And then we're just going to write text symbol for the first list. we're going to write the psi L sin field system. System field, sorry. So that we know it is on level 1. Then we're going to write the at line selection event, and we're going to write a case using the psi L sin system field. And when that equals 1, we're going to write one more time another text symbol, this time 2, and I'm going to write also the psi L sin one more time, and I'm going to copy this and do the same for 2. So I create my text symbols. Yes. Yes, save. And because I changed from language, it's asking me if the long language differs from the original language. The longer language is English and the original language is Spanish. So if I want to maintain the original language, I want to change the original language. It's going to be English now, my original language. Okay. Okay. Yes. Now for the first one, this is going to be called the basic list. When we double click the basic list, then we're going to be presented with the second detail, no, the first, sorry, detail list. And the third is the second detail list. Activate our text symbols, go back, activate our program, and now let's try it. Let's run. And now we can see we display the basic list and the psi L sin is 0. And here, for example, you will have all the data of a program. And you notice this icon is added when you add the add line selection event. So we can double click here, and it takes us to our first detail list, and the psi L sin is changed to 1. Another option is that we can select this and click on the icon choose, and it takes us to the second detail list. And if we want to navigate between our list, we click on back, and we can always double click to navigate further one more time. So this basically is an example of how you can create list and detail list on the second level, third level, fourth level, and so on, building up the hierarchy you need of lists. This is really important when you have a basic list and you want to show details of that basic list on another list. So now, let's write an application example of a detailed list. Let's write a program that shows us the uses in real life of the detailed list. So for this program, we're going to keep working with the flight connections program and the tables of the flight information. So the flight connection with detailed data should be displayed on the basic list. These are read from database table spfle. After that, when you double click the basic list on the details list, the flight schedules for the selected flight connection should appear with the respective detailed data. These are read from the data base table S flight. To do so, we need to do some things before. We need buffering row specific data in the hide area. So, in order to be able to access the key values of the selected row when a basic list row is selected, you have to implement the following concept. For each basic list line, The appropriate key values are kept in the program in the hide area. When a row is selected, the data that has been hidden for that particular row will be made available again. Data flow for line selection. The following graphic shows the entire line selection block of the example program. In this block, basically data, here flight schedules, is read and output by means of the hide values that have been transported back to the source field. For example, in this graphic, we have the start of selection. We select this field from the SP fleet table into the corresponding fields of our working area. Now we write those to the screen, and we also use the hide ABAP statement to indicate which are the key values of our write statement list. So these values are transported, the key values are transported to the values that are defined in the hide ABAP statement.